All right.
Coach Andy, can I borrow you, please? Yeah. So, this is one of my new favorites. It's something that, like I said, Professor Joubert shared with us in his last seminar, the reverse fireman. And it pairs really nicely with the Kouchi Gari that we've already been messing with. So, I get my cross grip, maybe have another grip. And I'm looking to start getting to sleep near the end here. You guys see this? Grabbing four fingers underneath. This is my new favorite sleeve grip. Like, forever I was just using cuff grips on the sleeves. This is good a lot of the time. But for a standing context, for judo, this is really nice because I can break, like I was saying, a lot of the time one-handed, which there's not many other gripping variations. You can actually break someone with a strong grip one-handed. And it also limits his ability to reach for my leg because my hand is underneath his hand, right? My hand's on top, there's not much stopping him from being able to reach in and go for wrestling shots. But here, it makes it really difficult for him to reach low, and it makes it difficult for him to keep a grip on my collar. Both are really, really nice things to have the one to read. So I break, I start to circle, I go for my Kouchi Gari, and now I'm gonna bring my head underneath Andy's armpit, and I'm pulling down with these two as he rolls this way. See how smooth that was? I'm not like trying to go crazy at first. Break, circle, block. See how I get underneath? I start facing the lateral side. I drop to my knees and I'm pulling Andy over me. I'm ready to come up and keep this control. Everybody follow so far? Yeah? One more time? One more time. Bring circle. Coast. Make sense? Questions, comments, concerns? No? Go slowly like I did the first couple. As you get really comfortable with it, you'll be able to add speed. But we're looking to create continuity of motion. One smooth, continuous motion. Good there. On two.